Hello, everyone. Welcome to week 4. This week, we will discuss policies for promoting renewable energy and energy efficiency. I hope you enjoyed the past 3 weeks and are ready for more exciting insights in the world of sustainable energy. I am Laurens de Vries, Associate Professor at Delft University of Technology in the Faculty of Technology, Policy and Management. My colleague, Emile Chapin, will join me later this week. Renewable energy sources are essential for limiting climate change. Sustainable energy technology is developing rapidly, but still the share of renewable energy in the global energy mix remains small. Why? And what can be done to speed up the transition to renewable energy? To find answers to these questions, this week will be dedicated to electricity markets, because in the end, market parties are the ones who decide whether to invest in renewable energy or not. We focus on electricity markets because most renewable energy sources produce electricity. We will start with an overview of how electricity markets work in order to understand what needs to change. In the first module, we will learn that markets can be an efficient way to match electricity supply and demand. We will look at the two types of markets, organized power exchanges and bilateral markets. An important aspect is how these markets affect investment decisions. Next, we will investigate why electricity markets fail to limit CO2 emissions and to integrate renewable energy on a large scale. We will also discuss why there are separate policies for renewable energy, for limiting CO2 emissions, and for energy efficiency. In the following modules, we will discuss these different instruments in more detail. In Module 4, policies for stimulating investment in renewables are discussed. Think of feed-in tariffs, feed-in premiums, and renewable portfolio standards. In Module 5, Emile Chapin will introduce the European CO2 market, which caps the total CO2 emissions from a number of the most polluting industrial sectors. By allowing companies to trade emission rights, the cost of emission reduction should be minimized. However, trade also causes complications. In addition to reducing CO2 emissions and promoting renewable energy, we also need to reduce our overall energy consumption. Our rapidly rising energy demand cannot be met with solely renewable energy sources. Improving energy efficiency is an effective way of reducing energy consumption without sacrificing our living standard or development goals. Emile will therefore provide an overview of energy efficiency policies. I will return at the end of this week with an outlook on future policies and market design for a fully sustainable energy system. Including a large share of renewables is a large challenge for the market. We will look at why this is the case. I won't be able to give you all the answers, but hopefully I can point you in the right direction. I hope you will enjoy this week, and I wish you all the best. See you around.